The government publishes the repeal bill, a key part of its Brexit strategy to sever ties with the EU. In a frank and personal interview, the Prime Minister tells the BBC she became tearful when she learned the election result.
Devastated enough to shed a tear?
Yes, a little tear.
Yes. At that moment, yes.
The parents of the terminally ill baby Charlie Gard walk out of a High Court hearing that's been asked to review his treatment.
I'm Simon McCoy. Also this hour, President Trump touches down in Paris as part of a two-day visit. While there, he'll hold talks with President Macron and attend Bastille Day celebrations. Conta's big test, she faces Venus Williams this afternoon.
Good afternoon and welcome to BBC News. The government has published a key part of its Brexit strategy. The repeal bill will convert EU legislation into British law after Brexit, giving UK parliaments the power to change them. The Brexit Secretary, David Davis, says the legislation will ensure we have a fully functioning legal system on leaving the EU. But opposition parties are warning they will vote against it unless major changes are made. Our political correspondent, Ben Wright, reports from Westminster.
Power is shifting. Brexit will end the supremacy of EU law in the UK. But untangling 40 years of rules and regulations is going to be complex and contentious. The bill published today will eventually repeal this, the 1972 European Communities Act. It will also copy and paste existing EU law into UK legislation.
We believe that to deliver a smooth and orderly exit from the EU, we need to ensure that people know they face the same laws and rules and regulations on the day after we leave as they did the day before. So there's no step change. People
in the House of Commons and opposition parties are clear they plan to battle the government over this bill.
We want to bring EU law into British law and we want to do it properly. This bill at the moment doesn't do it properly. So we find that the government intends to make changes behind closed doors. They may put sunset clauses or deadlines in. They're not being reasonable with the devolved administrations. We don't know how they intend to deal with disputes through this bill. They need to answer those questions.
The Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn and his team talks with the EU's negotiators. Clear the party would derail the government's new bill unless changes are made.
The Liberal Democrats too have warned ministers the government faces hell trying to get the repeal bill through here. And in the months to come, some Tory MPs may be tempted to vote with opposition parties to significantly shape the way Brexit happens through
the breaking point, isn't it, that after over 40 years of this very close political relationship with the EU, disentangling ourselves and leaving is a huge amount of work. And there's no doubt that within Whitehall, the more work they did on it, the more they discovered what needed to be done. So not only are you having to transfer over those directives, those laws, you then have to think, well, what new systems will be put in place, for example, on immigration?
Arithmetic has changed as a result of the outcome of the election, and Parliament has a job of work to do. Yes, there is a huge task to move legislation across, so the objective that things are the same the day after in terms of the law as they were the day before, we all agree with, but you look at the bill concerns that have been expressed by us and by other members of Parliament. Now, the government has
that
a choice.
That would block Brexit, wouldn't it? Let's face it.
No, not at all. This is absolutely not the case, because the Labour Party voted, the vast majority of Labour MPs, in favour of triggering Article 50. We campaigned for Remain, but we accept the outcome of the referendum. It is not about that. It is making sure that the process that the government chooses, this is about the government's choice. They've chosen to propose giving themselves these sweeping powers. They've chosen not to bring the Charter of Fundamental Rights across. These are their decisions, and they can change those decisions. And if they show movement, which it's open to them to do, then we can have a look at what they then bring forward. So, as the Labour opposition, we're putting the government on notice. You have a choice here. You need to listen to what Parliament has to say, because in the end, it's going to be Parliament that decides what legislation is passed and not just government ministers.
Do you think that it is possible to get all this work done in the time that there is? So by the time we come back in October, really, is when Parliament comes back properly, there's not much time left. Do you think it is possible to get this all through Parliament?
I think this is going to be extremely challenging, because we have two things we're having to do as a nation. One is 15 months to conclude the most